Yes, we did. So now that we are set up here, and the first round is, or the first turn, sorry, is in full swing, I will quickly run through the lists that we have here. Are playing Kruger 2 with Getarix, a Stalker, a Gorax, a Druid Welder, a unit of Druids with the UA, Thorn Blood Trackers, max unit, Nuala, a unit of Shifting Stones with a Keeper, a Gallows Grove, Wicked Pendrake, and a Thralk. In turn, Christian is playing Veil 1 with 2 Rakes, 2 Scythians, a Seraph, a Shredder, Typhon, 2 Forsakens, and 2 Strider Deathstalkers. I love how Legion lists always read so quick.
So, I'm here as well, of course.
Welcome back.
Yeah, welcome back. Alex just ran through the list. And Chandler started already moving everything up. The scenario we are playing is two front. So that's two zones, two rectangular zones you see there. Each player basically owns a zone, has an objective in it. And once you clear out that objective for 1 point, you can control the zone, the opposing zone for 1 point, and dominate it for 2 points, or you can dominate your own zone with your Warcaster for 1 point. As always, first player to 5 points wins the game via scenario.
Chandra is playing very quickly.
So we just moved the clock in a little so that we can actually see it. That actually was quite a long first turn for Chandler with 8 minutes.
Yeah. So this matchup is as much of a game of third rangers as anything. Both lists are going to be very mobile and playing a much of a cat and mouse game, if you will.
Both factions actually kind of specializing in that hit and run with their beasts.
Yeah.
Like Circle can put out Sprint.
And Vale's feet literally reads cat and mouse.
Yeah. And Vale has Leash in terms of movement modifiers.
And also Rampager should become very useful for her in the Circle matchup.
Yeah. If she can get to one of the Circle beasts, that is.
Well, she can always arc through any of her beasts at any time.
Can she?
Because of Oraculous.
Ah, okay. Does she have a Scythian in the list?
Two,
actually. No, not Scythian. Seraph.
She might.
For the slipstream.
I just read the list. I just don't remember it.
I've got him here. Nope, there's a Seraph.
Yeah.
So she's also able to slipstream stuff forward.
Slipstream and Leash is a very unpredictable combination.
Yeah. And gives Christian an ability to set up his models in unexpected angles for next turn.
Yeah. Christian already has to think where he will position his beasts so as to not place them too far ahead. He's moved pretty much all of his battle group except for the Seraph and one of the Scythians onto the hill in the middle again just to grab that plus two defense on round one.
And just as a quick FYI, the second German team has drawn Australia 1 for this round, and I don't know if any other pairings, but Philip Sharper, Rätsel, is actually playing against John Dennison, so that's a Crooks versus Retribution matchup. I don't know right now what the other pairings are, but we will find out. And of course on the streaming table set up next to ours from the American crew, there's the matchup between USA Stripes versus Germany Dichter and Denker. But back to Canada Goose versus Sweden Nobel. So Christian basically moved everything but a few solos up on that hill.
Those are the two Strider Death Stalkers.
Okay.
Which are already defense 15.
Probably Shepherds back there.
Yeah.
And also have Stealth. The Death Stalkers.
right now.
So Chandler's deliberating what to do with this turn.
Any further that he moves, he will already enter Legion's threat ranges.
Okay.
So the Druid Cloud Wall is completely out of the question because of Isle of Sight and basically all of the Legion list. He might try and go for an aggressive feat with Kruger and just stall the Legion advance with the speed debuff to prevent any charges and then maybe gain a foothold in both zones.
Yeah, that might actually be a good idea.
Chandler is calculating threat ranges.
So he's calculating threat ranges.
Okay, it might be too quiet on the stream, but Chandler just literally said he might jam Kruger Ballsteed into the table.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we're going to see a feat now.
Yeah, he's probably just running everything up, jamming it into the Legion.
Yeah.
Into. Just reiterated his wish to go balls deep.
Yeah.
And,
who wouldn't love that?
Yeah. Okay. So let's see what he actually does here.
Yeah, he's thinking about TKing himself 2 inches forward as well.
Hey guys.
And the wild Tim appears.
Total silence. What's up? We'll have Kieran as a guest commentator tomorrow, one of our games.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so he does TK himself forward to catch the back, the beast in the back line as well.
Okay, I'll do what I did before, head over to the table and feed the chat with live info.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
So he TK'd himself 2 inches forward, caught
and
everything, or at least everything on the hill, feeds, and now pushes everything off the hill. Well, everything back. Some things off the hill.
So everything is now 3 inches further back and has minus 2 speed, and will probably, if Chandler now proceeds to run his whole list in front of Kruger.
Yeah, Christian can't get at him.
I mean, Chandler mentioned that he was worried about the Typhon sprays getting onto Kruger, which is not that hard to engineer. Tracker's moving forward now. Oh, running forward. Closing LOS to Kruger.
And putting models just in the way of any advance.
I mean, if he TK'd himself forward and he cast Stormwall, he might be sitting on one transfer.
Yeah, looks that way.
So he is living dangerously right now.
Yeah, but on the other hand, what can really get to him in that opposing list? Okay. So the rakes can still jump, right?
They can still jump, yeah, but they are now speed 4 and jump 5, so that's a total of 9 inches with reach 11, and they look to be further away from Kruger than that.
Yeah, they do.
At the same time, Vale herself can actually just arc a couple spells onto Kruger once she gets line of sight. Oh, counter magic goes up. So there goes that plan. And the cloud wall goes up against the Deathstalkers, more so than anything else.
Yeah.
Thank you. Stalker runs
into a position to strike at everything that comes even within spitting distance of Kruger.
So, that is a very ballsy, aggressive move from Sergal.
Yeah.
Christian just mentioned that, the whole aggressive turn from Kruger was very intimidating to him.
So since Chandler started, and if I'm seeing this correctly, Kruger is towing his own zone. It doesn't look like he can get anything into that zone. He can still run.
He can still run the Deathstalkers.
I always forget that a speed debuff doesn't mean he can't run. I don't know where I got that from.
Christian now just requested Kruger's base stats again,
which are 50,
trying to 50. Determine whether assassination is a viable option right now.
Yeah. But does he have a viable option for assassination?
I don't think so. Counter magic is up, so spell assassination is out the window. All he has is Typhon sprays.
And he has to. He doesn't have to clear models for the not for the sprays anyway.
No. But he has to get Typhon up there and then hope to get through one transfer and kill him with two more shots.
Kill him with fire. So
Typhon sprays at power 12, I think. Power 14.
So if he casts Stormwall, that's 3. TK'd himself, that's 5. He doesn't have any upkeeps. Now he should be sitting on 2 transfers.
Yeah, that's right. That's 2 tokens right there in the middle of the table. Yeah, so then...
Yeah, Typhon has power 14 sprays, but... Even a boosted hit has very, very low chances of one-shotting him. So, and he'd have to do it 3 times to force the 2 transfers. That's a no-go.
Or at least in the highly unlikely category. What? Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Wer hat gewonnen?
Benny.
Gegen Mike Pia.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. So breaking news, people. In the USA Germany match, Mike Pia lost to Benjamin Fuzzi on scenario with Signar. Benjamin. I don't know which
scenario or assassination. Sorry? scenario?
Scenario. You press him out of the scenario with Haley 3 and push everything back, and that's game.
Wow.
Yeah. That was unsuspected.
Unexpected, yeah. Okay, let's switch back to this match.
Yeah.
So Christian is still deliberating what to do here. So first rake goes 5 inches.
I think he has to get something in there.
Oh, okay. So he is.
The rakes cannot jump. Yeah.
Yeah, the rakes cannot jump.
What? Welchen Kasse?
Der wäre das eins, der schlimme von mir.
Sehr geil, Benny, sehr geil. Okay, quick correction, it wasn't a scenario win by Benjamin, it was an assassination win.
Oh, okay.
Haley 3 assassinated Severius 1.
She does that.
And again, back to this game, we're sorry.
Ich hatte gerade eine Flasche. Hat der Tim die mitgenommen? Dann nehmen wir die auch.
Still very, very slowly moving everything, yeah. And very.
Yeah, I think he has to get stuff into the zones, and Chandler wants Vale to come forward.
Yeah, she has to.
Yeah. Well, this is a killbox scenario, so she's living very dangerously.
Yeah, and she's 10 inches from the back, apparently, so.
Okay. Slipstreaming on the Seraph, and. Okay, now he's activating Typhon. He'll probably actually not go for his destination, but just try to shear off the front line of Blood Trekkers.
Yeah. Just send Gregor the line.
Okay, so he's starting with the Death Stalker instead. Okay, casting his Animus on the Typhon.
We have about 85 now.
Yeah.
The Moorhouse game last round was up to 200.
Moorhouse won again.
Oh,
against Martin already.
Shit.
Pagani lost as well.
Pagani lost as well.
He forgot that Zebby had vision.
Were they playing England?
Okay, so two
You forgot awareness sometimes. You forgot awareness.
So that's two surprise losses for America and two different teams. So it's
different. Hast du ein iPhone-Ladekabel genommen?
Ja, richtig.
Ah, super. Danke. All right.
So Vayler is moving into the kill box.
Yeah.
Top of three. So Penny dominated a lot of the zones and the ball with maybe three.
She still has to move a little.
Yeah, so he looks fine here. So unless she gets TK'd back out of the kill box.
So she now moved into the kill box.
I like it because it gets newer things that haven't seen used. The problem is the release cycle. You have a strong caster in the air once these in there.
Yes, also put a beast or two, one beast. Towing the
that's one of his rakes, yeah.
Zone.
That's one of his rakes.
It's one of his rakes, okay. And oh yeah. Yes. And because he didn't put anything in the lower zone,
yeah, he's
Chandler keep, scored 1 point.
Yeah. He's seeding points, Chandler of course, but all of the Circle army is just threatening a huge alpha right now.
Yeah. And also kill the objective, control the zone right there, dominate the bottom zone as well,
yeah.
So going up to 4 points.
I have to
and
say that
really
was
the
a very timid turn on Christian part. Christian's part. He did not make any attacks.
It was.
Thanks for the compliments, Big Nose. All right, so Chandler is now going for those rakes.
Yeah.
I might as well remove the models from my bag that I'm not using.
Alright, he's boosting it to Kinesis onto the topmost rake. And misses. And he's trying it again.
We have to have that like one list that's like, well, I gotta be able to deal with this. This three list format now is really nice.
Still misses. Needed nines. That is already almost all of Kruger's stack gone.
Yeah. So he's now running to the back of the zone.
Like the little bitch he is.
Yeah, way behind his army.
Those casters are fine.
Way behind his army, so that he's safe from any retaliation. That still is not the only way that this rake's gonna die.
Yeah, I mean, there's Blood Drake is there, there's Druids there, even before all of his heavies going.
Yeah. Christian's preparing the cards for the rakes already in anticipation of Chandler.
We don't know who Chandler declared as prey.
Yeah, no.
For the Blood Trackers. It might actually be Vale herself.
But he's just lining him up.
Yeah, like a firing squad.
Yeah.
You would have to play test every single thing plus the game to make that something that would seem. I'm part of, I talked to DC personally when he made them, so I've written a bunch of
All
right. So one of the Blood Trackers is out of range for the rake on the hill.
Yeah.
The others are just shooting at the rakes. And one of the rakes is the prey.
Yeah, the topmost one.
Dice minus three, 8 points into the rake on the hill. Someone hits. A dead.
All right. That is the first rake gone, and he moves the prey to the second rake.
So you switch the prey to the second rake.
Yes.
And now
has
to hit.
Wow, 12 days.
Yeah, 12 hits. He's really rolling here.
You could say he's on a roll.
Yeah, you could say that.
Ba-dum-bish. Okay, that rake is left on one.
It kills it.
Okay, prey goes up on Typhon now, and the last three Blood Trackers. Okay, and the bottommost Blood Trackers are in range, looking for sevens to hit. Oh yeah. Typhon has his Animus up, so he heals 1d3 every time he takes damage.
Yeah.
Which is pretty good. We're not going down as easily as those rakes did.
Okay, so you just halved that last damage roll. Bruce. Now he's making the reform movement.
And he's jamming apart.
Yeah, he's jamming him up, making it harder and harder for Christian to...
contest scenario.
Contest anything in the scenario, not just the...
Yeah, he's pretty much bound to go up to 4 CPE this turn.
Yeah, I would take a guess and think that the Stalker will move into the objective.
Yeah. He might actually go for some lower value model and try Throg.
Yeah.
Like, Throg is over here.
Ah, okay.
On the edge of the zone, so he might just charge it in first and see how much he does. He can. He might kill it already.
Yeah.
And then he doesn't need to commit the Stalker.
Druids have not activated yet either.
Yeah.
So it's really spacing out the Blood Tracker unit there. Now the Druids are next and are moving up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Laying down clouds again.
Yeah, Cloud City.
Yeah. Well, that actually does help him against the spell assassination, since Vale herself does not have either side.
My favorite format of all time is Mangle.
Hang on.
I love it. I would play 100
cards. Yeah, she doesn't. Wow.
But that's like the Mark 1 thing. Everyone's like, Mark 1 suck. Awesome.
No one except Lilith, I think, has other side in leader. So he's warping strength with the Stalker, he's putting it into the objective. Okay.
And the
objective is down, and...
So now Chandler's basically up to 4 points, because there's nothing else in the zone. He sprints. And
playing a fast game.
Now the pressure's on to Christian in a big way.
Okay, short update on the German game. Benny won by assassination, obviously. And the funny part is that he assassinated in a big part with storm lenses.
So electro leaps.
No.
Yeah, electro leaps, and then guns from the storm gunners and
nice.
So storm lenses, America, they're a thing. Play them.
England, USA is already 2-2. Maybe want to see what's going on there.
Okay, Chandler shipped the clock to Christian, who is now under big pressure to put stuff into his own zone as well as Chandler's zone. And he now only has 3 heavies, that is 2 Scythians and Typhon left. And the 2 Strider Deathstalkers. So he still has some means to remove a decent amount of models.
Yeah.
The thing is that most of them is chaff, and he now also has to think about scenarios, so he cannot really afford to play a big attrition game right now.
The problem is, doesn't have enough models to put enough pressure on both zones. So
yeah.
Kruger's
it all depends a little on how much the Typhon sprays remove.
Yeah, but still, Kruger is a warlock with 7 Fury, so he can use 3 TKs
yeah.
and put out 3 models out of his own zone. He only has to clear only has to clear the bottom zone next turn.
You can actually use 40Ks since... How did I say just... Did I just say 40Ks?
Yes, you did.
Because he has Arcane Wonder as his objective. So he gets...
Arcane Wonder says he gets one upkeep spell.
All right, yeah. And counter magic is still up, so Typhon will have to remove some druids with his... Did it produce diamonds?
You encourage me to be vulgar.
So Christian upkeeps leash.
Okay, that Death Stalker moved into the zone. He's already contesting. Ready to be TK'd out of the zone next turn.
Yeah.
Misses his shot onto a druid, I think.
Yep, it goes into a druid. Applause erupting. We're waiting to hear from Tim what happened in the England America 1 matchup, because that was 2-2 until a few moments ago. I think the final matchup went down just now. And if I'm not entirely mistaken, let's wait for Tim. He's up.
Yeah.
He's on his way up.
Okay, Deathstalker's still shooting onto some Blood Trackers, starting to clear up a path for Typhon to move into. I'm pretty sure Christian is thinking about moving Typhon into, or slipstreaming Typhon into into Kruger's zone and just spraying down
as many models as he can. Yeah,
as many warrior models as he can.
Yeah, he probably won't get
he actually
to
I mean he will sorry he will not have any trouble contesting the zone if he feeds, because he will get a pseudo sprint with every war beast he has. So Vale's feat says
at the end
each
of
his battle group models at the end of the turn gets to advance again for each enemy model in her control.
Yeah.
So that's basically everyone. And that means a pseudo sprint for his whole battle group.
Yeah.
With no free strikes as well. Yeah,
but
and he's slipstreaming Stefan.
Can he position his heavies in a way that they A contest the zone, but B are out of range for Getarix and the Stalker? Probably not.
Probably not, yeah. Oh, he forgot to move the Seraph. It does. I'm no judge, but I think, yeah.
Calling over a judge,
yeah.
to
So the question is whether the Seraph can slipstream, can cast slipstream and then forfeit movement and then still slipstream the Titan.
Yes, he can, because end normal movement triggers if he forfeits movement.
Right.
He just doesn't advance.
His initial reaction was also that he triggers slipstream even if he sacks movement.
Yeah.
So they just changed his opinion.
Okay.
The Seraph does have to move. And Chandler graciously allows Christian to move the Seraph.
Yeah.
Trigger slipstream.
And he doesn't get the aiming bonus,
yeah.
But so it's four heavies actually, not three.
Yeah. Right, but the Seraph is not really, I mean,
that's,
it's classified as a heavy, but it's very lightweight.
Yeah. So the Blood Track has lost their boss and they had to feel promoted.
Yeah, I think as well that Christian was a little too timid on turn two.
Yeah.
And did not move up aggressively enough, and he ceded scenario play completely to Chandler.
Yeah,
who is now in complete control of the game.
Yeah, although it really does make it look easy, Chandler, that is.
Krieger does that.
Yeah. I've lost games as this to Krieger as well. And I've been assassinated my fair share by Kruger.
So he moves Vale
into the zone,
up into his own zone, next to the Gallows Grove. leashes Typhon forward again. And yeah, that is a good position for Typhon now to move into the, all those troops there. You just feed it.
So he puts Chiller on Typhon, which means... No, he doesn't. He puts it inside.
So wherever Vale is right now, we have to remember that she won't be there when the turn ends because she gets to live as well.
Okay.
So he will probably move to the bottom leftmost edge of his own zone. Okay, Typhon is activating. And moving into a good spray position.
Yeah.
Oh, he's spraying on the Stalker. Okay, he's trying for the hard seven. Misses. That is dice up one on that Warpwolf.
Yeah. Dice minus one on the Warpwolf, which 10 points to the 5. So the spirit of the Stalker is out. Minus one.
And
on
the last one.
12
points.
That's 22 boxes from 25 of the Stalker, so the Stalker's on 3 boxes. He probably would have died if the first one hit. Now, does he have any attacks or shots left to kill the Stalker? Probably not.
Scythian charging into the zone. Shredder is charging into the zone as well. So he has now two models contesting Kruger's zone, which can of course still be TK'd out. But
yeah.
Oh, they just remembered that counter magic was up. So Vale could not have cast Insight. And they are now trying to... They're now both trying to restay. Alright, so they're removing Insight and Tenacity on Vale. And they're keeping the damage on the Stalker.
That kind of sucks.
Yeah, so. and instead he spends the fury that he spent on inside healing Typhon for three damage.
So the rabbit shredder kills a druid
in
the zone, and
in
the
zone.
Two models contesting.
I mean, it would have been 4 points less damage on the stalker without insight.
Yeah.
But
still
also
a significant amount, but
yeah.
There's another druid gone, or another blood tracker, I'm not quite sure.
That was a blood tracker.
So now the beasts are standing in the middle of the table.
I think Typhon will move into the bottom zone with the feet movement.
Yeah.
And the Deathstalker is now moving up aggressively. The second one is moving into the zone. Shredder moving further inward, as expected, and then
engaging another blood trigger and one of the druids.
Yeah, and then Typhon is moving into the zone as well.
Scythian.
Oh, Scythian. Okay, that's not Typhon.
Yeah, Typhon is.
Typhon is in the middle between those zones. Yeah. So it's going to be interesting where Vale ends up standing after he's done. So obviously he has to move a lot of stuff into the enemy zone.
Yeah.
But that is also seeding, or he's giving him one of his heavies basically. Yeah. So Vale is towing his zone and the hill.
She doesn't have to stay in the zone, she can't contest anyways.
Oh, right. But he still did. He still said that for some reason. So.
Yeah.
And he's holding his own zone with one Scythian.
Yes, Penguin. Kruger was already defeated in the second round.
Okay. And the Seraph below Vale is also in the zone, so.
Yeah.
Now basically all but one or two models of Christians are not in the zones.
And now he switched the clock and Chandler has 29 minutes to clear either zone.
Yeah. Fire goes out on the stalker already.
Chandra does here. He could try and kill the death.
I mean, his best chance, I think, is Vale Zone, since he could easily TK the Seraph out of the zone, and then maybe try go for
does he have the range from way back here?
Well, if he charges one of his own models.
Yeah, okay.
And then try and slam the Scythian out of the zone. That would already be game.
Or he could try and TK the Deathstalkers out of the zone and just kill those beasts. A primal, two primal heavies in Gedorix.
Oh, yeah, sure. He still has Gedorix in reserve, right?
Yeah. and could heal the Stalker enough to send him into Typhon.
Going
the upper zone and going for the bottom zone.
Okay.
Sascha kann ich nicht sagen. Bei dem, was ich sehe, müsste Robin eigentlich gehen.
Okay, so Alex is going to take a quick look at the Germany USA Stripes matchup. The Druids here are moving up and are starting to do what exactly? Zone was deliberately placed so that Typhon is not in his melee range. The other druids are moving up. One on the hill. One up there in the middle.
Yeah.
And they are putting thunderbolts into force bolts and trying to pull Typhon out of the zone. I'm not quite sure if Typhon actually is completely out of the zone. Shredder, I think, and is now deliberating his next move. What comes next? So there's the second game finished. Over on the American table.
Jay wins against Christian.
Okay, so Jay Larson just won against Christian Metz. And Germany USA Stripes, it's 1-1.
1-1.
1-1, yeah. Mercurio lost to Assassination. And Norbert is sitting next to us.
Yep. Amazing.
Right now.
What's the story in Canada overall?
I think they're all still going.
No games resolved. Wow.
No games resolved. Okay.
I think.
But Chandler's up 4 control points.
Yeah. Ooh.
And in a very good position to just, if he clears,
Kruger's
his zone,
just so aggressive
in that
scenario.
Five.
It's ridiculous. So he moves Kruger up here and feeds and pushes everything that he had off the hill and then controls both these zones and takes out the objective and he goes up to 4. Within 2 turns.
Perfect storm.
Yeah. So now he's, Christian is just trying to claw his way back into a game.
This tournament has been rough going for everyone.
Yeah.
No one's had an easy ride, even first round.
Hell no.
Yeah. That's how it should be.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
No easy wins. You have to work for it. So, both Deathstalkers are either dead or out of the zone.
So what has Kruger done so far?
The Druids pulled Typhon out. I'm not entirely sure if he's completely out of the zone. There's a knockdown marker. I'm not entirely sure what is knockdown. And
that's
the Deathstalkers are out
shredder.
Of the zone. It's probably the Shredder, yeah. Christian doesn't have any CP at the moment. So it looks like the Scythian and the Shredder have to go for Kruger to win this game. Let's see if and how Chandler can engineer that. So it looks like one of the other games actually is finished. And it's the game, the table over, Christopher Redding against Dylan McCann.
But Christopher seems to have won.
Charles Soong. I'm not entirely sure, I think Christopher is the last.
I would be surprised, I think he won. Still shooting down Typhon.
Yeah. So now he's porting Gatorix right
into melee with the Scythian.
Yeah.
And once he manages to get rid of that Scythian. And he forgot Primal. That should still. That should still work though.
Yeah. It entirely depends on if Typhon is actually in the zone or out. We can't quite make out if he's.
Yeah.
Still towing the zone. Alex will just go quickly and check. Because if Typhon still needs to die, then it's a whole other ball game. So it looks like he's not in. Okay, Typhon's not in the zone. So it might be possible, but yeah.
It's a post 17. It still dies of one for Gatorix, so
yeah,
he would probably
Chandler just realized that the stone's ported Gatorix and he can walk up Prime Limb and then activate the stalker at Gatorix. I actually didn't realize it myself.
Well, I thought because he was so upset about it that Gorex was out of range to Prime Limb.
Yeah.
So he removes the shredder with the
bite.
With the bite. And
Dice plus 3.
13 already.
Scythian has 30 HP, I think. It's 13, that's another...
8. And he has 7 left. Or 9 boxes. Yeah, 9 boxes left.
Yeah.
And that's game.
And that's game.
And scenario victory for Chandler.
Okay, what happened?
We restart the stream.